Okay, the final item of business this evening is a member's business debate on motion 7973 in the name of Jackie Dunbar on VAT burn campaign. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put. I'd invite members wishing to participate to press the request to speak buttons now or as soon as possible. And I call on Jackie Dunbar to open the debate. Around 7 minutes, Ms. Dunbar.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I feel so honoured to be leading the debate this evening, and I'm proud to add my name to the calls for the UK Government to scrap VAT on sun cream of factor 30 and above, as these products are essential health items. I thank colleagues from not only my own benches but also from the Labour benches who have supported my motion, because their support has allowed this debate to go ahead tonight. I'd also like to welcome Amy Callaghan, MP, to the public gallery this evening. Welcome to our, or your, Parliament, Quine, and mark yourself at home. Members have had the opportunity this afternoon to drop in to chat with Amy about the campaign in the Parliament, and I thank colleagues from across the Chamber who have taken the time to do so. I also want to wholeheartedly thank Amy for her campaigning on this issue, being a survivor of skin cancer herself. She has been a relentless advocate, and her work is hugely welcome. And if her bill passes, it will, without a doubt, save lives. I also thank Melanoma Focus, Melanoma UK, Young Lives versus Cancer, Teenage Cancer Trust and Skin, who have backed Amy's calls and who continue to work for this vital change to VAT to be enacted as a matter of urgency. Presiding Officer, cases of melanoma have more than doubled since the early 90s. 16,000 new cases of the skin cancer are diagnosed across the UK each year, resulting in 2,300 deaths. As many as 90% of cases of melanoma could be prevented by staying safe in the sun, and this includes using sunscreens of SPF 30 and above with a 4-star UVA protection rating. Wearing sunscreen is one of the simplest things we can do to protect our skin against the risk of cancer, but 1 in 8 of us don't wear it purely down to cost. Some just cannot afford it. Amy's campaign will stop families being priced out of buying sunscreen and make it more affordable for everyone. And Amy's bill is a simple and inexpensive one that could save countless lives. Australia, the US, and Canada have already removed VAT-style taxes from sunscreen, and there's nothing stopping the UK doing the same. Cases of melanoma skin cancer are increasing, yet most cases can be prevented if people are sun smart, including wearing factor 30 plus sunscreen. Public polling indicates that many folk find the cost of sunscreen just too high, and with the current cost of living crisis deepening, and with summer fast approaching, cost is likely to deter increasing numbers of folk from buying sunscreen. Major retailers Tesco and Asda have recognised cost as a prohibitive barrier to folk buying sunscreen. And indeed, to their credit, Tesco reduced the price of their own brand sunscreens by 20% in 2021 to offset VAT. And this move from Tesco followed a consumer poll in which 57% of respondents said the product was too expensive, and 29% claimed that they would wear it daily if it was a little bit cheaper. Asda called for VAT to be removed as part of a sun safety campaign in 2013. And I would join Amy in calling on all supermarkets to take steps in the absence of action from the UK government to make sunscreen as affordable as possible. Removing VAT from factor 30 or more sunscreens will both make sunscreen more affordable to folk and will send a powerful message to the UK government about the importance of skin protection. With the impact of climate change meaning increasing temperatures in the UK, this measure is becoming increasingly urgent. Presiding Officer, in the US, sunscreen products have been federally exempted from VAT-style taxes since 2012. In Australia, they're exempt provided that they're marketed principally for using as sunscreen and have an SPF rating of 15 or more. Melanoma Focus believes that the reduced VAT revenue from this policy would be offset by reduced melanoma skin cancer cases and therefore reducing costs to the NHS. The Getting It Right First Time NHS England Review of Dermatology highlights high and increasing skin cancer demand, with 200,000 surgical operations carried out for suspected skin cancer every year, and skin cancer rates doubling every 14 to 15 years. It highlights the need for additional workforce to meet current and future pressures and recommends that raising sun and skin awareness is needed to reduce pressures on dermatology services. So the message is simple. Remove VAT from sunscreen and save not only lives, but also pressure on our NHS, which, as we know, is already under increased strain. It's quite frankly shocking that the UK government cannot see this benefit and have not taken action to exempt sunscreen from VAT. Presiding officer, we know VAT is a policy area reserved to the UK government, but there is action that the Scottish government can take. And I'd ask the minister if she would write to her counterpart in the UK government to request that VAT be removed on sunscreen of factor 30+, or give this parliament the powers to do so in Scotland. I would also ask the Minister if she would consider working with Retailer Scotland to explore actions which could be taken to increase access to sunscreen. There are simple steps, but are steps which will save lives. Presiding Officer, in closing, I again thank Amy Callaghan MP for all her work on this issue, and I add my support to the campaign and call on the UK Government to take the action needed. And I look forward to hearing the contributions from across the chamber tonight. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms Dunbar. We move to the open debate. I call first Rona Mackay to be followed by Sandish Gulhani. Up to 4 minutes, Ms Mackay.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm especially pleased to be speaking in this important debate tonight, and I thank my friend and colleague Jackie Dunbar for bringing it to the chamber. Presiding Officer, May is Melanoma Awareness Month. There are 16,000 new cases of melanoma, the deadliest form of skin cancer, diagnosed each year across the UK, with 2,300 people sadly dying. This is largely a preventable disease, as 90% of cases of melanoma could be prevented by staying safe in the sun. And that's why this campaign, launched by my friend and colleague Amy Callaghan, is so vital and important. Presiding Officer, I'd like to say a few words about Amy, who's here in the chamber, as we know. She's beaten melanoma twice while in her teens and early 20s. And I'll do my best not to embarrass her, but she is a remarkable young woman. She was my office manager when I was elected in 2016 until she won the constituency of Eastern Bartonshire in 2019 in stunning style, beating the sitting MP, Jo Swinson. I never doubted her ability to do that or to tackle issues head on. She's dealt with considerable health issues with amazing courage and determination. And if anyone can win this campaign, she can. Amy is a winner. Her VAT Burn campaign aims to remove VAT from sunscreen products of SPF 30+ and a 4-star UVA protection rating. We know that using an effective sunscreen is the safest way to enjoy the sun and protect the skin, but sun cream is expensive. As we've heard from Jackie Dunbar, research shows that 1 in 8 people actually don't wear sunscreen because it's too expensive. And as someone who's always used a factor 50 sun cream, and I still have to limit my time in the sun to avoid burning, I know how necessary this is. And I've never understood why the higher the factor, the higher the price. It doesn't seem to make any sense. Melanoma Focus, who are backing this campaign, along with Teenage Cancer Trust, Skin Melanoma UK, Young Lives versus Cancer, Mascot, recommend that factor 30 plus sunscreen is a healthcare item, and I wholeheartedly agree with them. Presiding Officer, there's no valid reason for retaining VAT on sunscreen products. This policy change would cost the Treasury in the region of £40 million per year, a drop in the ocean when it comes to saving lives. Yet despite cross-party support, the UK Government has refused point-blank to take this initiative of removing VAT forward, and I think that's shameful. In the 15 to 44 age group, melanoma skin cancer is the second most common cancer in males and the third most common in females. 1 in 36 females and 1 in 47 females will be diagnosed with melanoma skin cancer in their lifetime. and cases are increasing, yet most cases can be prevented if people use high-factor sunscreen. Presiding officer, we're in the middle of a cost-of-living crisis, and admittedly not yet this year, but our summers are getting hotter, so there'll never be a better time to review the policy of paying VAT on a healthcare item. It's good news that supermarkets Tesco and Asda have recognised the cost as a prohibitive barrier to people buying sunscreen. And as we heard Jackie outline, Tesco have reduced the price of their own brand by 20%. Asda called for VAT to be removed. And Morrisons have also pledged to pass on VAT reduction. Removing VAT from sunscreen would not have been possible under EU rules, but is now possible. Perhaps this is the only benefit of Brexit. In the US, sunscreen products have been federally exempted from VAT-style taxes since 2012. In Australia, they're exempt, provided they're marketed principally for use as sunscreen and have an SPF rating of 15 or more. So it's high time that common sense and a duty of care to save lives prevails, and these health items are exempt from VAT. So can I thank again my colleague Jackie Dunbar for bringing this to the Chamber, and wish Amy Callaghan all the best with her commendable campaign. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms McCann. And I call Sandus Gulhani to be followed by Ruth Maguire around 4 minutes, Dr Gulhani.
Thank you. I want to start by taking a look at sun creams, which recommends Asda own brand at £3.50, Boots own brand at £4, but safety issues it raises with Hawaiian Tropic at £14, Green People at £25, Alba at £12, Tropic at £28, Ultrasun at £28 and Clinique at £26. So if you look around and look for the best type of sun cream which works most effectively, it's not about price. It's about what's inside it. And what's inside it, that costs more as you go up on the different factors. Looking at skin cancer, that's what I really want to talk about. And this is abnormal cell growth on the outermost part of our skin there, and that's the epidermis. And what happens is ultraviolet light damages the DNA and triggers mutations, and that rapidly spreads. Now, it's more pronounced in people with fair skin and people who are more susceptible to sunburn, but it doesn't mean it doesn't happen to people of all colours. Having a large number of benign moles and a family history of skin cancer is also a risk factor. And we need to also be clear that it's harder to diagnose in people with darker skin and also children under 15. And a lot of that has to do with the fact that at medical school, the only things I saw were from rashes to moles to cancer were on people with Caucasian white skin. There are different types of skin cancer. Some are very rare. So the three most common are BCC, the basal cell carcinoma, which is sort of a pearly white lump. You get squamous cell carcinoma, the SCC, and that's a pink lump with a rough or crusted surface. And then melanoma, which is the most aggressive and dangerous. And we've heard that 12,000 people are diagnosed with it annually. About 1,200 malignant melanomas, the most serious, are registered each year. And it's important that sun cream isn't just the answer, because it's not just about sun cream, which is very important. But we also need to be sun aware. We need to make sure that we spend time away from the sun, especially during those hottest times. We also need to make sure that we're covered up. So we wear a hat, we wear long sleeves. And though tempting, as we don't get a huge amount of sun here in Scotland, we do want to go and enjoy it as much as possible. It is that that we need to be wary of. Now, what I really want to talk about is how people go about looking at moles. What do they need to do? So if you're out there and you've got a mole or you're not sure, then what I would like you to do is get a ruler and take a picture of that mole. That allows you to have a mole with a line, which means if you take more pictures of it, we know how big it is. A, B, C, D, E is what we want to be doing. A stands for asymmetry. So you want to look to see if it matches. B is the border. Is it irregular? Is it rugged or blurred? And C is for colour. Is it uneven or is it the same colour through? D is diameter. So it's about the size of a 5-pence piece. And E is evolving. Is it changing over time? So if these things are happening to you, we need to be clear that you should present to your GP and your doctor, because I think it's time that that gets photographed and sent to dermatology. A small spot can still be very significant. So this is very important if you are concerned, and this is what the sun causes. We need to limit our use of sunbeds as well. The proposal to remove VAT on sun cream, which would cost the public purse around £40 million a year, is definitely worthy of further discussion. But as I said at the start, it's important we all wear sun cream, no matter what our colour, and we need to spend time out of the sun. People need to be educated in what is important when it comes to the moles that they have, and please present to your GP if you're concerned. And I declare my register of interest as a practising NHS doctor.
Thank you very much. Dr. Gulhani, I now call Ruth Maguire to be followed by David Torrance. Around 4 minutes, Ms. Maguire.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I congratulate Jackie Dunbar for securing this debate and bringing the important topic to the Chamber. My thanks also go to Amy Callaghan, MP, who's been campaigning tirelessly for the removal of VAT on sunscreen products recommended by the NHS. 16,000 new... 16... Forgive me, number blind. New cases of melanoma diagnosed each year across the UK, with 2,300 people dying. 90% of cases of melanoma could be prevented by staying safe in the sun. Now, we heard those shocking statistics from Jackie in opening. However, I think it's important that these numbers are repeated and highlighted to press home how crucial action, like removing VAT on products, could be in preventing cancer and saving lives. And prevention is what this campaign is about. Sunscreen is often seen as a luxury, something somebody buys when they head off on holiday. And perhaps we only think about it in Scotland after the searing pain of being sunburnt, which has probably happened to all of us at some point, and we've maybe even joked about it. But would we, if we knew, and I quote, "Play Scotland, stay safe." It only takes one blistering sunburn, especially at a young age, to more than double a person's chance of developing melanoma later in life. Education in a young person's life is crucial to their understanding of the world, gives them tools that influence their decisions throughout their life. As parents and carers, we like to be role models for our children and young people, encourage them to drink water and stay hydrated, eat healthily, get outdoors and move around and play, especially when the weather's nice. And when we do manage to get them off their devices and outside, we teach them not to speak to strangers, to be careful of traffic. But do we always make sure they use sunscreen? And if not, why not? £3.50 might be cheap on an MSP's salary, but for lots of families, that still impacts on their weekly money that they have to spend. And when we talk about being safe in the sun, we know sunscreen alone is not enough. With the cost of hats, summer clothes and sunglasses, cost to families can be significant. Presiding Officer, over the last wee while, the cost of living crisis has been high on the agenda. Energy prices have risen, interest rates have soared, and people have endured an increase to the cost of their weekly shop. With the Met Office reporting the average hottest summer day is between 4 and 7 degrees warmer than previously recorded, it's vital that families are able to afford to protect themselves and their children. A survey by Tesco showed that 57% of adults think sun cream is too expensive. 29% said they would wear it daily if it was a little cheaper. And nearly a third of parents said they can't always afford to apply sun cream to the whole family, often deciding to apply it just to their children. As we've heard, Tesco's already absorbed the cost of VAT on all products in their own brand range, meaning a reduction of 20% in the price. And I know that Morrison's backs Amy's campaign too. As summer approaches, I urge families who are feeling the pinch with the cost of living crisis not to skimp on buying sun cream, and to remember it's not the brand, it's the ingredients that keep you safe. Presiding Officer, Melanoma UK projects over 1,900,000 people in the UK are expected to be diagnosed with melanoma in 2025. It's vital that action is taken now to remove the VAT on sunscreen so that protection is affordable and easy for young people, for our families, to save lives and prevent cancer. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Maguire. And I call David Torrance to be followed by Carol Moch in around 4 minutes, please, Mr. Torrance.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I would like to thank Jackie Dunbar for bringing this important debate to the Chamber today. I'd also like to express my gratitude to my Westminster colleague, Amy Callaghan, MP, for leading the VAT Burn campaign for the UK Government to remove VAT from sunscreen products that have significant health benefits. There are 16,000 new cases of melanoma diagnosed each year across the UK, yet 90% of the cases could be prevented by staying safe in the sun and using sunscreen that is at least SPF 30 with a 4-star or above UVA protection rating. Skin cancer is one of the most preventable cancers, yet sunscreen products are still subject to VAT, creating significant barriers to access. Cancer affects so many of us and our constituents' lives, and making a simple and effective change, removing VAT from sunscreen products, could have enormous impact on people across the country now and for generations to come. The benefit of scrapping VAT on sunscreen products is well known, and the UK is a decade behind the US in exempting sunscreen products from VAT-style taxes. If the last 3 years of COVID and the last 13 years of Tory austerity has taught us anything, is that we cannot put a price on our health. And at any time when thousands of families across the country are facing incredibly difficult decisions regarding their finances, it's clear that making sunscreen more affordable and readily available is a common-sense approach the UK Government needs to take to save lives. No family should feel they have to forsake sun protection for the sake of cutting costs. According to a 2021 survey, 15% of adults think sunscreen is too expensive, and 29% said they would wear it daily if it was a little cheaper. Nearly a third of parents surveyed says they can't always afford to apply sunscreen to a whole family, often deciding to apply it just to their children. Although it's incredibly welcome that some supermarkets have made this decision to absorb the cost of VAT and to reduce the overall price of some sunscreen items, it is essential for the UK Government to recognise that sunscreen is an essential product, not a luxury, and should be treated as such for VAT purposes. I join many of others in condemning the UK Government's response to the campaign. The argument that government funding would reduce if VAT on sunscreen products were scrapped is almost laughable, considering the estimated cost of skin cancer to the NHS is £100 million. To put this into perspective, less than 0.5% of revenue generated by the Treasury from VAT comes from sunscreen products. It is also massively disappointing that the UK Government has placed responsible for these issues on retailers, many of whom are small businesses and individuals, many of whom are suffering as a result of a cost of living crisis. The UK Government previously committed to reviewing VAT on sunscreen products, and I join others in their calls for the Government to consider this commitment once again. I also very much support the second component of the VAT ban campaign, which is to improve education and awareness around skin protection and sun. As May is Skin Cancer Awareness Month, where prevention, detection and treatment of skin cancer takes centre stage, and this debate today is helping to give the important topic the political attention it deserves. Research from Melanoma Focus shows that 35% of Scots rarely or never use sunscreen, when in the UK, with only 15% always using it. This is despite the fact that 44% of Scots report getting sunburn at least once per year. We have seen record temperatures in recent years as climate crisis make us more susceptible to heatwaves and intense periods of direct sunlight. As we reach the warmer months, raising awareness of skin cancer prevention and symptoms is absolutely essential. I am proud of a number of initiatives that Scotland have introduced, such as sunburn regulations, improving sun awareness education to thousands of pupils and increasing the number of clinical nurses and specialists in skin cancer, including in Victoria Hospital in my constituency. Thanks to the tireless and invaluable work of researchers, the NHS and medical profession, campaigners and cancer charities, these initiatives have made a tremendous impact on the way we approach skin cancer and prevention awareness. In conclusion, Presiding Officer, it is clear as much more has to be done, and the contributions to this debate have highlighted just how much support VAT Burn campaign has across all areas of Scotland. It is our duty to make these products more accessible and affordable to our constituents. I am reassured to see that the Scottish Government's priority to improve the experience of outcomes for people affected by all cancers across Scotland, and with the UK Government's support of a VAT Burn campaign, we can continue to improve the lives of people affected by skin cancer and their families and loved ones.
Thank you, Mr. Tonnes. I now call Carol Mochan to be followed by Ash Regan, around 4 minutes. Ms.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And can I also thank Jackie Dunbar for bringing this really important debate to the Chamber. It is right we debate this topic this evening because it is important that we consider this campaign and discuss all options that allow people to be safer in the sun. As the motion states, the vast majority of melanoma cases could be prevented by staying safe in the sun, and so it is critical that we are always raising awareness of the key components of good sun safety practice, such as been mentioned, wearing clothes that provide some protection, finding shade, and taking extra precautions if, for example, you have any or many moles. I think I would like to also add that it is only right when we debate in this chamber that we take the opportunity to look at where the Scottish Parliament has legislated in the past to tackle the incidence rate of skin cancers in Scotland. And people may know that a former Labour MSP and presiding officer of the Parliament, Ken McIntosh, delivered legislation that directly addressed the lack of clear and visible warnings surrounding the use of sunbeds, which we know has direct links to skin cancer, sunburn and other skin-related conditions. This was important then and it remains so now. Possibly even more so, given that through analysis into Britain's high streets, these businesses, such as tanning salons, are concentrated in areas of the country that already have high levels of deprivation, and so perhaps target some of our specific communities. So it's really important that we do get a chance in this chamber to discuss these broad issues. Yeah, of course.
Jackie Dunbar.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I was just wondering if Carol Mochan was sharing me, first of all, apologising for not bringing this up in my speech, but unions have done a huge amount of work to ensure that sun creams are used as part of the PPE in a lot of workplaces. And I was just wondering if the member would join me in thanking them for all the hard work that they've done with that.
Carol Mochan.
Lovely, thank you. And I'm sure the member will understand that the next part of my speech very much addresses that particular issue, so it's a very welcome intervention. Presiding Officer, the role employers play in protecting employees, we all agree then, particularly those who work outdoors during periods of high temperature, cannot be understated. During last year's heatwave, the TUC and the STUC rightly called on employees, on employers to provide sun cream in advance of the need for protection from the sun when employees were working outdoors. Indeed, from a workplace perspective, the TUC argued that sun cream was PPE and should be considered, though. And although it is within the rights of an employee to refuse to take up the offer of wearing PPE, in this case, sun cream, for whatever reason, it should remain the case that employers are fully expected to still make that offer to the wider workforce. Often when we think about the times of someone may be at highest risk of damaging themselves in the sun, we think about being on the beach or being overseas, but the NHS rightly advised the public that you can burn in the UK even if it's cloudy, as we've heard, and sunburn, as we've heard, increases the risk of skin cancer. So we must always be aware of the risk, no matter where we are and no matter what the weather is. Therefore, Presiding Officer, it is absolutely right that we debate tonight the matter and that we do look at all the avenues, including the campaign that has been spoken about today. So I do thank Amy Callaghan, MP, for the opportunity to discuss this in the Chamber. We can and we must do better for people. In concluding, Presiding Officer, my party and I are fully appreciate and acknowledge the importance of protecting skin from the sun. And in this place where we have the power to do something, we should always make sure that we do what we can. We must increase awareness, and everybody tonight, I think, has done that. So thank you again for bringing the debate to the Chamber and to all the speakers this evening.
Thank you very much, Ms. Mochan. And I call the final speaker in the open debate, Ashley, again, around 4 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank Jackie Dunbar for bringing this important issue to the debating chamber this evening. And I would also like to lend my support to our colleague Amy Callaghan for her very important VAT burn campaign, obviously to remove VAT from sunscreen of SPF 30 and above. And obviously it's timely that we're debating this here this month, because obviously it's Skin Cancer Awareness Month, and I think has been mentioned by some other speakers this evening that this is, despite what many might think, this is actually one of the sixth most common cancer to be found in Scotland. So it's right that we take this opportunity to raise this issue, to discuss it, and we've obviously taken the opportunity to do that this evening, covering such issues as medical things to look out for and different brands and so on. I am somewhat of an expert in this topic, being a redhead who likes to spend as much time outdoors as possible, and also having two redheaded children. And we are so into sunscreen in our house that we actually spend time discussing the merits of different brands against each other, because not all of them perform or are as pleasant to use as others. But clearly, sunscreen is not a luxury item, and that's why I support this campaign. It's very important to use sunscreen, especially for children, as we know that one very serious burn as a young child can seriously increase your risk of going on to develop skin cancer later in life. And I think this is a good opportunity as well to talk about sunbed use. I know some members of my family have become very addicted to using sunbeds, and I know that's far from rare in Scotland. I think there is a dilemma there. Obviously, the weather that we have in Scotland, I know that tanning is very popular at the moment, and many people like to look tanned. And I think the reason for sunbeds being so popular in Scotland is that because they contain some of the rays that you would naturally find in the sun, it can give people a bit of a boost to their mood. And so I think that's why, one of the reasons, at least they're popular in Scotland. But we need to obviously remind people that sunbed use and overuse, indeed, of sunbeds can be an extreme risk factor for going on to, again, develop skin cancer of one type or another. We've made mention of the weather so far, and it sometimes seems like the latitude that Scotland is at, that we very rarely see the sun, and when we do, we want to rush out and enjoy it. And I think that's actually the right thing to do. I think being in the sun can make you feel better, as we've discussed, but also it obviously allows your body to generate vitamin D, which is obviously a very important vitamin, or even a hormone as it's sometimes described, in your system, which can help people to remain at optimum levels of health. And I think we've seen over the last several decades at least that many Scots are now seriously deficient actually in vitamin D. And I wonder if this is at least partly because we've significantly moved away from what would have been that traditional Scottish diet, which certainly in my mother's generation was very heavy on oily fish. You know, they used to eat herring very regularly, and that's obviously got a large component of vitamin D in it. But it is quite difficult to get all the vitamin D that you need from your diet. And so it's important also to expose your skin to sunlight, but I must stress, not to the point where your skin burns or becomes pink. So if you're interested in finding out, I mean, most of us will know at what point that is and how many minutes that takes. But if you are interested, you can go online and you can check the various different skin types. You can see where your skin type falls on that and how long it might be appropriate to expose your skin without sunscreen in order to retain some vitamin D into your system. So the important message is get outside, enjoy the sun. If you can exercise while you're doing it, so much the better. Don't burn yourself. Sunscreen is obviously very important and not a luxury item. And I support this very important campaign. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms Regan. I now call Jenny Minter to respond to the debate. Minister, for around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and thank you for everyone's contributions to the debate. It is a privilege to respond to this debate as Minister for Public Health and Women's Health. I'd like to thank my colleague Jackie Dunbar for bringing this motion to the Chamber today, and also welcome Amy Callaghan to the Chamber of our Scottish Parliament. And very much for driving this campaign, not only here in Scotland, but also in Westminster. As others have done, I want to praise Amy Callaghan for using her personal experience with skin cancer to campaign for VAT to be removed from sunscreen products. Now, I'm old enough to remember the campaign Slip, Slop, Slap, or perhaps it's simply because I'm a peely-wally Scot with blonde hair, who burns easily, that it stuck with me. As Amy Callaghan referenced in her debate in Westminster, this campaign originated in Australia and New Zealand, and it was aimed to reduce unhealthy sun exposure by slipping on a shirt, slopping on sunblock, and slapping on a sun hat. And the Scottish Government recognises how important tackling skin cancer is. As others have said, malignant melanoma is the fifth most common cancer in Scotland, affecting over 1,000 new individuals each year. This is excluding non-melanoma skin cancers that are, of course, much more common, with over 12,000 cases registered in 2019. And to my colleagues here today, thank you for sharing such important contributions, really raising the profile and informing people about the importance of sunblock and being aware of the impact of sun on our skin, and it's great to see such a united front across the parties in identifying the need to support the public in preventing skin cancer. Now, Ruth Maguire highlighted that one bad bout of sunburn doubles the chance. And it's not just the sunblock, but also the other protections, and also highlighted the impact of the cost of living on this. David Torrens quite correctly said we can't put a price on our health, and we need to take the common sense approach. Jackie, you asked a couple of...
Minister, could I ask you just to adjust your microphone? I think that the audio is struggling to pick it up.
It's on. You don't want me to start again? No. Jackie Dunbar had a couple of asks from me with regards to writing to the UK government to make changes or to give us the powers to make the changes. And I'm very happy to do that. Rona Mackay talked about higher factor, higher price, the £40 million, a drop in the ocean in saving lives, which I absolutely agree with. And Sandesh Gulhani gave us a very helpful way for us to monitor any moles that we have with the A, B, C, D, E. So I thank you for that. And Carol Mochan, again, the importance of raising the profile within this chamber, also the TUC, and raising the responsibility of employers. And as you said, we can and we must do better. And Ash Regan, thank you for highlighting the importance of vitamin D. I know a lot of people that suffer from SAD, but also to ensure that it is done safely, and also the online check list to check the length of time you can stay with sunblock on. So thank you, Ash, for that. As you're aware, cancer remains a national priority for the Scottish Government and across NHS Scotland. We're developing a new ambitious 10-year cancer strategy to launch very shortly. We conducted a public consultation on what its aims and principles should be, and there was general agreement on priority areas, including placing an emphasis on the role of prevention. The new strategy will take a comprehensive approach to improving patient pathways from prevention and diagnosis through to treatment and post-treatment care. Its vision will be supported by a 3-year action plan. And we know that, and this has been said in the debate, we know that the earlier cancer is diagnosed, the easier it is to treat. And that's why the Scottish Government is committed to raising awareness of all forms of cancer, including melanoma, through our Detect Cancer Earlier programme, which we continue to invest in. And you might have spot the early bird posters across Scotland and short videos that I would ask members to share on their social media if they haven't already. Work to develop a new earlier cancer diagnosis vision in Scotland that will outline the future of the Detect Cancer Early programme is nearing completion. This vision will form part of the new cancer strategy. The programme helps ensure those with suspected symptoms of cancer are put on the right pathway at the right time. Our aim is to reduce later stage disease so that cancer, when detected, is more likely to be curable. We know that melanoma is often detected early and contributes to its high 5-year survival rate of over 90%, and we hope to continue this trend. However, the ideal is to prevent cancers in the first place. This is possible for only some types of cancer, but reducing risk factors to help prevent cancer is one of our new ambitions. As this motion recognises, the risk of both melanoma and non-melanoma skin cancers are increased by exposure to ultraviolet or UV radiation, both natural sunlight and tanning lights. And as Carol Mochan said, this Parliament introduced legislation by prohibiting the use of sunbeds by those under 18 years old, including a requirement of proof of age. Secondly, the Act states that written health information must be provided to any person before using a sunbed. And thirdly, it prescribes the content and form of notices to be displayed in sunbed premises. And I would encourage anyone who is considering using a sunbed to consider its implications and the higher risk of skin cancer it produces, especially among those under 25 years of age. When enjoying the outdoors, as Ash Regan talked about, the best way to enjoy the sun safely and protect one's skin is to use shade, clothing and sunscreen. Sunscreen doesn't protect completely from sun damage on its own. However, it can be useful for taking care of the parts of skin not under shade or cover. It's important to highlight the importance of using a sunscreen with at least SPF 15, if not higher, and with 4 or 5 stars. As members of this Parliament have said in this debate, the power to set value-added tax or VAT rates remains reserved to the UK Government. And I would like to echo my colleague's call on the UK Government to remove VAT on sunscreens with a sun protection factor of at least 30 and those with at least a 4-star UVA protection rating. And as I said before, I will write in as a result of this debate to the UK Government. As Amy Callaghan stated in February this year in Westminster, removing VAT from sunscreen is not a radical idea. In fact, when asked, most people are surprised, if not shocked, that VAT is charged on sunscreen. I believe this simple but necessary act is one of common sense, emphasising to the public, as Ms Callaghan has said, the importance of using sunscreen as a sun safety measure. Presiding Officer, in closing, I would like to thank again all those who have spoken to support our fight against cancer. I want to reiterate to members and those watching the debate that the Scottish Government's enduring commitment to reducing the burden of cancer in Scotland through a wide range of actions, from preventing the onset of cancer and detecting it earlier to strengthening our treatment options and providing wider supportive care.
Thank you very much, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I close this meeting of Parliament.